As you know, solids, liquids, and gases are the three states of matter that we have here on Earth. But why do we have solids, liquids, and gases? It all deals with the kinetic theory of matter, which says that particles of matter are always in motion. So it might be a lot of motion or it might be a little bit of motion, but they are always moving. The reason it's the kinetic theory of matter is because kinetic energy is the energy due to motion. So the more movement there is of those particles, the more kinetic energy those particles have. Solids have a definite volume and a definite shape. Definite means that it does not change. So if I have a solid and I put it in a new container, it's not going to change its volume or its shape just because I've put it in a new container. The particles are moving, but they are in place. So they're in place and they're just moving back and forth a very, very, very small amount. The particles are close together and they're in a pattern like I've shown here. Some solids are called amorphous, which means that over a long amount of time they will lose their shape. So glass will do that as well as wax. Liquids have a definite volume, but they have an indefinite shape. Indefinite means that it can change. So when I have a liquid and I put it into a new container, it will still take up the same amount of space, but it's going to take the shape of whatever container that I've put it in. It's going to spread out as much as it can in the bottom of that container. The particles are still very close, but as we can see here, they're more random. And the particles are going to slide past one another instead of being in those very specific locations like we had for the solids. Gases have an indefinite volume and an indefinite shape. So depending on what container the gas is in, it will both take the shape of the container and it will fill the container as much as it can. So if I have a gas in a small container and then I put it into a big container, it's going to take up as much of that big container as it can. The particles have more space between them and they are more random and they're constantly moving around all crazy and they are colliding with one another. There are two other states of matter that exist, just not naturally here on Earth, and they are plasma and Bose-Einstein condensate. Plasma is a conductive gas that only exists at extremely high temperatures. Even though we don't have it naturally here on Earth, 99% of the universe is made of plasma. Bose-Einstein condensates were predicted in the 1920s, and they were finally made in a laboratory in 1995, which wasn't that long ago. Bose-Einstein condensates only exist at extremely low temperatures. When I have it one state of matter becoming another state of matter, that's called a phase change. And during a phase change, the temperature of that substance does not change. So if I look at my diagram here, I have heat energy increasing on the bottom, and I have temperature here on my y-axis. If I look at the bottom here, below 0 degrees, I have ice, and once it reaches 0 degrees, that ice starts turning into water. And as that happens, we notice that the temperature is just staying the same. I have that nice horizontal line. Once all of the ice has become water, the temperature will increase in the water again. But once it reaches 100 degrees, it's going to start turning into steam or gaseous water. As it's turning into that, or as it's going through the phase change, the temperature stays the same. Once it all becomes steam, then the temperature can start rising again. So what's happening is my heat energy is increasing, but the temperature is not always increasing along with it. What's happening during the phase changes is the attractions that are between those particles, keeping them close together, those attractions get broken by the extra energy. So during the phase change, the energy is increasing, but what it's doing is it's breaking those attractions so that the particles are more free or more chaotic. So when we have these phase changes, they can either be endothermic or exothermic. Endo means inside. So when I have an endothermic reaction, energy is being absorbed or brought into the substance. And it ends up breaking the attractions between the particles. And it makes my substance more chaotic, just like we saw in the previous slide. If it's exothermic, however, exo means outside. So the energy is leaving or is being released from the substance. And that ends up forming attractions between the particles. So instead of the particles being farther apart, if I release energy, they will be brought together and it will make my substance less chaotic or more structured. I have six types of phase changes. With melting, also known as fusion, a solid is becoming a liquid. The temperature at which this happens is called the substance's melting point. When something freezes, it's doing the opposite. It's going from a liquid to a solid, and the temperature at which that happens is called the object's freezing point. Notice that the freezing point and the melting point for a substance are equal, which means that for water, for example, the melting point is 0 degrees Celsius. The freezing point is also 0 degrees Celsius. It just depends on, are you starting as a solid or are you starting as a liquid? Vaporization is what we call it when a liquid becomes a gas, and that can happen in two ways. Either the substance can evaporate, which means that that happens at the very surface of the water, so like on the surface of a puddle, for example, or the substance can boil, which we see with boiling water, for example, those bubbles start to form on the bottom. And so boiling happens throughout the substance. Evaporation only happens at the surface. It takes much more energy for a substance to boil than it does for it to evaporate. Condensation is the opposite of vaporization. So it's when a gas becomes a liquid. Sublimation and deposition are special because sublimation and deposition skip that middle step. So it's going from a solid directly to a gas without going to a liquid in between. And deposition is the opposite, when I have a gas and it becomes a solid without becoming a liquid in between.